We move on now to take leaders' questions under Standing Order 29. And Deputy Micheál Martin.
Is the Taoiseach constituent? He is. I mean, in spirit as well as in the flesh. Taoiseach, I want to raise with you the unacceptable situation in relation to the approval of life-saving drugs that has come to the public domain again in the last week. In particular, there are three drugs that I can identify: Pembro, Nevo, and Ibrutinib. Pembro has been quite astonishing in terms of its impact on melanomas and the prospects for its impact on lung cancer and kidney cancer is quite exciting as well. Most oncologists will testify to. And Pembro and Nevo and indeed Ibrutinib, which deals with CLL, which is a type of blood cancer, the first two deal with melanomas, all have very significant improved survival rates. All are in use in most of the EU 25 countries, have been FDA approved by the European Pharmaceutical Agency, and indeed approved by our own Pharma Economic Unit, which is normally the area of contention when disagreements arise. In Ibrutinib, for example, it suggested that there's 90% survival rates early on, which is quite dramatic. In Pembro, up to 50% of those treated can expect significant survival rates. Now, Taoiseach, there has been an unacceptable delay in approving this because the Pharma Economic Unit approved this in February. My understanding is the group within the HSE was not due to meet until June. To be fair to the Minister for Health, he's brought forward that meeting to Wednesday. The Compassionate Access Programme has been closed. It only now exists for existing patients. No new patient can access these vital drugs. And the prospect of families, and I met a family over the weekend, and other deputies have as well, is that they have to get up to maybe €10,000 now to start paying for this drug that's been approved by the Pharma Economic Unit. I think it's scandalous what's going on, and I think it speaks to a lack of an overarching policy here. And I want to put it to you, Taoiseach, that can you take every step to ensure that the approval process is sorted out as quickly as possible? My understanding is it has to go to government after the HSC committees approve it. But secondly, that we would look at a ring-fenced fund, either top slice overall government expenditure by 0.4%, that would give you $200 million a year. Put it into a separate fund that we build up over the years that would deal with new technologies and new drugs.
Thank you, Deputy.
That would have a real impact from a policy perspective, or the sugar tax could be used for it. But we need to do something different to an ad hoc approach that's pushing the can down the road, hoping the issue doesn't come up straight away. And that's what's going on here because of current budgeting and all of that.
Thank you very much,
and people's
Deputy.
Lives are being lost as a result of it. And it's just not good enough.
Okay, thank you, Taoiseach.
Well, nobody wants to be put in the position of determining life and death. This is going to continue because new drugs are being tested and are being assessed and analysed and created as time goes on. Every year you get a number of new ones coming on. Deputy Martin's raised Pembro and Nevo. Obviously, Minister Harris, as a new minister in the department, has asked that the meeting would take place tomorrow on that. The state's paying out $1.7 billion every year on drugs, and that's got a potential to grow by about $400 million over the next number of years. So there's always an analysis that has to be carried out. You can't put a price on a life, I understand that. But as with other countries, Cancora, Ireland needs to ensure that access to emerging high-cost treatments, and there are more continuously high-cost treatment drugs coming out, so as to prioritise patients who could benefit most and at the same time ensure that these drugs are affordable to the taxpayer. I think it's also important to say that these decisions should not be made by government or by ministerial order. They have to be made through the National Centre for Pharmacoeconomics and clinical decisions that determine their value and their benefit for patients who can who can avail of them. As Minister, as Deputy pointed out, obviously the drugs referred to here are currently being considered by the HSE. Hopefully, when they meet tomorrow, they will make their conclusion as to whether these drugs show value for money. Obviously, the Minister has asked the HSE to conclude these deliberations quickly. He wants to know. And that means a memo has to come to government, and the government have to consider the cost implications of what's involved there. Nobody wants to be put in a position, particularly any minister, of saying if you don't approve this drug, somebody's going to die. And obviously, as time goes on and as the years come in, there will be new treatments that are exceptionally expensive and still give a great benefit for people with particular ailments. I know of the AbbVie down in Sligo, the treatment for hepatitis C, which is not just a treatment, it's an absolute cure. The joy and consolation it brings to people who are able to avail of it and have its curing qualities means a whole new emphasis on life and living for them. So as I say, the group is meeting tomorrow. Minister needs to know. I want to wait and see what their analysis is and what their conclusion is. And Minister will bring a memo to government as soon as possible. Take the point, Deputy Martin, that the question of dealing with this is part of an overall strategy within the health system. Obviously, almost 14 billion going in there. You could identify areas where maybe savings could be made of a somewhat serious nature. But you don't want to be in a position where somebody needs a treatment of a very expensive drug, and if they don't get it, that their life is going to be taken away from them sooner than it would naturally occur. So obviously, I want to see the clinical decision here from those who understand these things, and inform the minister, and the government will make a decision on the affordability of those, so that the taxpayer knows that they're getting good value for the funny money that they spend, but that patients can have their lives saved where that's appropriate.
Thank you very much, Deputy Martin.
Taoiseach, but that's exactly what's happening. That's exactly what's happening. There's patients now awaiting this medication and cannot get it in our hospitals. The clinicians are clear. Any oncologist I have spoken to is very clear about the efficacies of these drugs. The pharma economic unit, which normally determines cost-benefit analysis and survival rates and weighs all that up, has made its decision. It made it in February. And this committee in the HSE wasn't going to meet until June, while people are waiting. And this isn't the first time this has happened. There's a significant hiatus between the pharma economic unit making the decision and some group of officials in the HSE making a decision. It's just not good enough. It's in no way is it good enough. And what group of officials are going to second guess the formal process of evaluation that has already taken place? Greece has this drug in operation. Greece are using these drugs in their hospitals. Greece is more fiscally challenged than we are. We just lack any sense of urgency of someone to cop on and get at this thing, particularly when it's approved. And we should be encouraging and nurturing new technologies. That's what this country was about one time. I'm not saying that the pharmaceuticals arrangers are not. They have to be challenged as well. But we're not playing it properly either as a country. We're just ambling along, delaying, 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 and people's lives are at risk. And also the whole idea of having a value approach which says we want to encourage innovation and investment in research and development. These drugs, for example, MSD in Cork and in Carlow, those plants are key to the processing of this. We have to fund innovation as well before you can have any generic drugs. But the bottom line, Taoiseach, this has been passed by the Pharma Economic Unit for use. And I think there's an urgency and an obligation now to get this over the line as quickly as possible for the young people who are now awaiting this. And the impact is quite dramatic. It's going to come at us again in the next couple of months. As I said, Pembro is going to be there for kidney cancer. It's going to be there for lung cancer. I've suggested a way to grapple with this once and for all. Create a ring-fenced fund. No one in the country would object. If €1 of every 250 euro that we spend every year, and we do as a country, if €1 out of every 250 was just put aside into a ring-fenced fund that would build up over time, use it as leverage to negotiate and develop a strategy. But it's there separate from your current health budget, which has been bled, can't deal with it as it is. And I think, Taoiseach, it's time. I don't want to be coming up and leaders' questions every few months with the next drug and so on. I welcome innovation. If someone did this to penicillin in the last century, where would we be?
Thank you. Taoiseach.
Well, Of course, the country has invested heavily in innovation and research. And over the next 5-10 years, you're going to have X number of new, very expensive treatments that will come forward as a result of many of the research students who are working in pharmaceutical companies now. We don't know the extent of what they will be when they're eventually tested and come on the market. Some of them would be exceptionally expensive. The Minister has ordered that committee to meet tomorrow. He will get a conclusion on that. I expect that whatever the outcome there, he will bring a memo to government. I'm conscious of this. It's lovely to have the concept of the ring-fenced fund for all the different sectors, but life is not like that, really. I would say that out of a 14 billion fund, if you look at, and the minister will look at the effective spend of much of that in areas within the HSE, I'm quite sure there's a significant amount can be saved there. But be that as it may, the concept of having a specific fund for very exceptionally expensive drugs that bring treatment for a smaller number of patients who really need it because of their particular ailments, everybody can understand that that would be nice to have. But I'd like to think that we can have speed up the process here of getting a decision and a conclusion, so that those patients can have, they can have hope restored to them and confidence that the state hasn't forgotten about them. And there's a balance to be struck with all these things. We are paying over $1 billion in drugs every year, and that's going to rise by another $500 million over the next number of years. And these are things that have to be taken into account in respect of the taxpayer. But then you can't put a price on human life.